Welcome back to my channel, the IIT Encoder. This is an editorial of Educational Ground, Food Forces Round 95, rated for Division 2. As you know, there has been a problem with Problem A, so this round has become unrated. So even if you didn't perform well, you have plenty to learn from the problems. I'll be posting the editorial of the first three videos today and the editorial of the next three videos tomorrow so that you get a break to learn more things. So, in this, you are given an array A consisting of n integers. For each position I, either the array is locked or unlocked. You can take the values on the unlocked positions, rearrange them in any order, and then place them back into the unlocked positions. You are not allowed to remove any values and the new ones, or rearrange any values on the locked positions. So, what is your task? The prefix sum array is calculated, and your task is to minimize k, where k is the maximum j such that pj is less than 0. That means your task is to increase the prefix sum as much as you can. As you cannot move the locked elements, your task is just to sort the unlocked elements in the greater order, so that if the first element is locked, you can't do anything. The second element is locked, you can't do anything. But if the second element is unlocked, then make sure that unlocked element is the greatest element out of all the numbers that you have, so that the prefix sum is the greatest possible till then. So this is the only way you can minimize k, because at the rate which you increase the prefix sum, the k will drop. So if you put any other value except for the largest value which is possible out of the unlocked positions, then you will arrive at a contradiction that only the maximum value is possible. So this was a simple logic. Let us look at the code. So in this, I just accept the numbers. I just accept the L of I, whether they are locked or unlocked. And if it is unlocked, I push back the number in my num vector. Then I just sort the numbers, create an answer array. If the number is locked, then it is equal to R of I. Otherwise, it is equal to the number of J++, where J is sorted in a greater order. Hence, the unlocked elements are sorted in a greater order. And then we just print it. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you liked it.